What's up, everyone? My name is Bryce Benz. I'm a 19-year-old kid from South Florida, and I go to school at the University of North Florida in Jacksonville. I'm studying abroad in China for 1 month in the city of Beijing. We will be studying international business and economics. I'm pretty excited, but at the same time, I'm not quite sure what to expect yet. So this is going to be quite an adventure for me. Don't know the language and don't know too much about China, so this is definitely going to be a learning experience for me. But I'm excited, and I can't wait to go to China.
Here we are in the car, going to Jacksonville International Airport, about to take off.
To China!
To go to China.
Beijing, ni hao, ciao, xi cheng.
I know. It's 3:30 a.m. I know very little Chinese, and this is the start
to a long adventure.
Well, the clock says it's time to roll, yeah. For all you people, for show. And maybe some should consider a place that's open till four. And lights go down and you're ready for the open road. Maybe there's a chance for show. Never really knowing if you'll be on the other side when it's time to come home.
Here we are at the bus going to Beijing. Going to our BizU, Beijing International Studies University, with our Beijing,
students. They're teaching us.
Yep, they're helping
the ropes,
us,
I guess.
Making sure we don't die, get lost, or both.
Here's our room. We thought it was going to be worse than this. It's actually a legit hotel. The beds are really low and pretty small. As you can tell, there's a little dump right below us. But McDonald's is over there. Boom, not too far. We are on the 17th story.
We showed up there and, you know, the culture shock hit us pretty quick. And the way the Chinese people think to the food they eat, it's just so much different. And, you know, you'd walk along the streets and you'd see the food stands and you'd know it's been out there all day, you know, from the seafood too.
Well, here we are eating duck at the Peking duck restaurant here in Beijing. And then here is the head of a duck. And I'm about to try it. Hopefully I don't die.
It smells pretty normal.
That's a joke.
Eat it. Man, I'm putting some soy sauce. Ah, oh, shishia.
No.
Eat it.
I just ate it. That's gross.
What are your feelings?
It's like, it's got some crunchy parts in there. It's like Jell-O with like a little bit of crunchiness in it. But the fact that you know it's brain makes it even worse.
Pizza Hut. We've been here for 6 days, and we're giving in. Chinese food just doesn't cut it.
We got there the first day, and the smog was terrible. You couldn't see a single thing. Proximity of people in China too is really crazy as well. Apparently there are 30 million people that live within the city of Beijing on unofficial reports because they have not done a census in some years because it's gotten out of control. Walked in the bathroom for the first time and there's, you know, on the floor there's a hole and that's where you did your business. There's a lot of, you know, really poor people in China too. That you'd see them foraging in the garbage and, you know, collecting water bottles just to make ends meet. There's this one lady who was begging to our friend, but we had no idea what she was saying, and one of our friends thought she was trying to sell him the baby that she was begging with.
She's trying to sell him the baby.
Oh, I was like, really?
He doesn't want to buy the baby.
It was really neat to see a completely different culture and to really get a feel for how the Chinese people lived. As soon as we got over into China, we did what any tourist would have done as well. Go to the markets, and we bought everything from Beats headphones to pearl necklaces, suits, you name it, we pretty much bought it. And also taught us how to speak some Chinese as well. As you can see, John Mack here speaks Chinese very well.
Why?
yet.
Big.
Too big. Here we are in Beijing. Checking out the markets. We've bought too much stuff already. We're gonna get a haggling though. Mostly because we bought a lot of stuff, so we have to haggle with them.
Describe how cool the Forbidden City is. As you can see behind me, and all around.
So here we are at the Summer Palace. This palace was built by one of the empresses of China, and she used all of the money that they had to build the Summer Palace instead of funding the war, and that's why they lost the war. But the palace here is huge, it's gorgeous, there's a lot of gardens to see. Here we are on the wall, Great Wall of China, as you can see, and I'm exhausted. I've been walking the wall for maybe 5 minutes, and I'm out of breath. Well, we have a long way to go, so hopefully I don't keel over here on the wall. We are 888 meters up. We started at around 100 meters, so climbed quite a bit. You can see here, it's kind of a misty day. It's in a very cool ambiance. Here we are on the bullet train going to Shanghai.
Yeah, did you get flat tab like 30 seconds after arriving at Shanghai?
Yeah, I'm down from 200 to 100. I don't know if it's a good deal, but you know, it's kind of off, so I figure it can't be too bad. Hey, I don't want to wait.
There's no license plate.
We are in Shanghai. We just got to our hotel. Check it out. Central Hotel Shanghai, and this
is awesome.
Check out our hotel room we just got here in Shanghai. This is ridiculous. Only paying $100 a night, and this is sick. There's marble everywhere.
Just got a room.
Oh, check it out, check it out. Here's our view of the city. We're on the 12th floor. And this is legitimate.
Shanghai. Number one department store right in front of us. I don't know what these other stores are.
It's raining out right now. It's kind of gnarly, but the city is sick. There's so much to do here. And we're trying to find our way to the markets of Shanghai, where
not
this all is
not known.
Acid rain everywhere.
Yeah.
We're actually, our lives have been shortened by 3 years because of the rain.
So when we went to Thailand, we spent 2 days in Bangkok and 1 day in Pattaya. Unfortunately, I accidentally deleted all the footage from the first 2 days in Bangkok. However, I do have the footage from Pattaya, which was an amazing day and also my birthday.
All right, so we have here the wild elephant with no seat belts or anything like that. The guy looks fine. He's picking his toes on while sitting on the elephant. Now he's beating it with a stick a little bit. I don't know what that's doing, but I would not have the balls to beat the elephant with a stick without a seatbelt on. But it looks pretty comfortable, so hopefully we won't die. Fortunately, the ground here is really hard. Maybe I should say unfortunate.
Now, we're listening to R&B while we're about to go on the elephant. They're pretty rickety.
Here comes the elephant.
I'm on an elephant right now.
That's a tiger.
Ma'am, just sit down here, you tap there. Ma'am. You up.
He's gonna bite me. We're about to go on our first dive. Water clarity doesn't look too good, but we'll see what happens. We're diving for about 45 minutes long, and we are gonna go about 5 to 7 meters, which is pretty shallow.
What up, guys?
So we just knocked off like 3 bucket list items in one day.
We had a great time. We went snorkeling while Bryce left us and went scuba diving because he's a certified diver. But we had a good time. We didn't get stranded on the rocks.
We went scuba diving too.
We did. Just now, though, we went free diving as well, which was pretty nice.
On behalf of the University of North Florida, Scoggin College of Business, and the rest of the university, I would like to thank the International Studies University for the warm welcome that you have given us and for the wonderful opportunity to come here and study in the beautiful city of Beijing.
So beyond the history and traveling around, the main reason that we were in China was to study. We took 3 classes. One was international trade, another was doing business in China, and the third was a Chinese class.
My name is Zhao Xiaohui.
Does that mean anything?
Yeah, of course, yeah. Zhao.
Every year U.S. will earn money from selling education to Chinese students.
So as a whole, China was an amazing experience. Being over there for a month was the perfect time. We met some really cool people and we did some amazing things. I honestly cannot think of a better way to spend the summer. Looking back on the trip now, I'm so happy that I went, and I just can't wait until the next adventure.